Now, 3 years ago, Israeli stocks were upgraded to developed market status. The move was heralded as a sign of success, but it brought problems. Israeli companies now have to compete with the US, Europe and Japan for investor attention. Now, for more on all of this, here's Blue Star Global Investors founder and chief investment officer. He's Stephen Schoenfeld, an exchange-traded fund based on a Blue Star index that has outperformed Israel's benchmark index this year. He joins us now from Tel Aviv. Stephen, thank you so much. It's a great pleasure to speak to you. Just give me a sense of how the global ETF industry give actually exposure to investors, to Israeli companies and the economy.
Sure, Francine. Good morning. There's now an ETF that tracks our index, the Blue Star Israel Global Index, listed on the New York Stock Exchange. That means that investors can trade in the U.S. time zone and get exposure to a benchmark that includes both Israeli stocks listed here in Tel Aviv, but also Israeli stocks listed abroad, including the U.S., the U.K., and even Poland. This gives investors exposure to a broader and more diversified portfolio of Israeli companies, which, as you mentioned, is more diversified and has outperformed the local Tel Aviv index.
So, Stephen, would it be fair to say that then for investors would be missing out if they just have exposure to Tel Aviv-listed companies?
That's absolutely the case. Israeli companies are very global in nature, just as the Israeli economy is, and therefore many of them list abroad, and many of them are household names that investors across Europe and the U.S. are familiar with. For example, SodaStream, which is in the kitchens of many of your viewers, is listed in New York, not in Israel. And so by ignoring Israeli companies that are listed outside of Israel, investors are not getting complete exposure. And in fact, in our index, we include about $40 billion of market cap that would otherwise be missing in not just the local Tel Aviv index, but also the MSCI and FTSE indexes for Israel, which both focus only on Tel Aviv-listed stocks.
Yeah, and Stephen, you know, we were talking to the chief executive of Mellanox just last week, and he was saying similar things, which is why he's now traded in the States. What does the Tel Aviv Bourse now need to do to attract or even retain some of these technology companies?
Well, you know, Israeli companies, as I mentioned, are global, and it's understandable, especially that tech companies want to be close to their customers. They also are very attracted to the U.S. market because they get analyst coverage, which can often lead to higher valuations. However, as investors recognize that Israel is more than just information technology, it also includes agricultural technology, biotech, defense tech, I believe that some of these companies might consider dual listing. The exchange also can do a number of things to attract these dual listings, working with the regulators to better harmonize the listing rules. And although my good friends here in the Tel Aviv financial community won't necessarily appreciate this, I do think the Tel Aviv exchange could extend its hours so it has more overlap with London and New York. Right now it has only about 1 hour overlap with New York.
Stephen, thanks so much for all of that. Stephen Schoenfeld, they're the chief investment officer of Blue Star Global Investors.